who are dead today, the three children who are dead in Newark, and the one that's in the hospital, they are in those conditions. They are dead kids and one in the hospital because Newark is a sanctuary city, because Newark did not do what it should have done, did not report the fact that they had in custody somebody who had committed previous crimes and was an illegal alien, and let that guy back out on the street, and he committed these crimes.
All right, Geraldo, is that a fair criticism of the city when you've got illegal immigrants, you've got people all over the country committing crimes, and there's a bigger, higher crime rate among people who are here legally than illegal immigrants?
2 points. First of all, this was the 60th homicide in Newark this year, and I'm sure Congressman Tancredo has not opined about any of the other homicides and only became interested in this one when it became clear that one of the six alleged perpetrators came to this country illegally at the age of 11. That's one thing. Number two, why was this person, this one of the six, around to commit this hideous crime? He was out because he had a 31-count indictment for the rape of a child, and he was out on $15,000 bail instead of the requisite $450,000 bail that he never could have made and never would have been on the street. It had nothing to do with his immigration status, and it's just being used by advocates of this crushing anti-immigration policy to make a cheap political point.
Absolutely untrue. Geraldo, please. Now let's go through this one. Go through this process as he has laid it out. 60 crimes, 60 murders committed in Newark up to this point in time. First of all, we have absolutely no idea, of course, how many of those murders were committed by people who were in this country illegally.
Wait a minute.
You brought this up. I'm saying that then you went on to suggest that the reason that this guy was out on the street simply was because the bail was reduced. But the reality of the situation is this, Geraldo, and you know this. That one reason, of course, that the bail was not set higher is because the judge did not have the information about him being an illegal alien.
He had a 31-count child rape indictment.
You're right. But
how much more would the bail be? $1 trillion?
But he could have been deported.
It wouldn't be a dollar.
Do you want him deported before you try him for child sex?
Yes.
For child rape?
Yes.
He's got a 31-count child rape indictment against him, and you want him deported before you send him to jail?
Let me explain one thing, and then we'll get back to Congressman Tancredo. Let me tell you what I think you're missing here, is that these lives of these college students may have been saved after this guy was charged with the serial rape of a 5-year-old, had it not been a sanctuary city, had they not hidden his illegal immigration status, he could have been deported. And the issue here, Geraldo, that you seem to be missing is this country is angry because of
the country is angry.
You know why? And it's nothing to do with race.
The country is angry because of political leaders who heighten the contradiction between different groups, who exacerbate tensions.
Because people are not. Let me explain.
Here's why people are mad.
Who are not speaking to the tradition of America as an immigration, as a country of immigrants.
Immigration has got nothing to do with it.
The congressman's grandparents, both of whom came from Italy.
What's that got to do with it?
We are a country of immigrants. We should be open-minded.
We're not talking about illegal immigrants.
The vast majority of these people are here, hardworking, law-abiding people.
Do you understand the difference? Do you understand the difference between the word illegal and legal?
Congressman, you were in Miami last year. You call Miami a third world city.
What's that got to do with it?
Because it is an insult to Hispanic Americans. You go to Miami and you call it a third world city. And you also falsely claim it was the murder capital of the country.
Don't change the subject.
Congressman, let me bring up a point here for Geraldo.
Three kids are dead in New York.
Congressman, we'll let you respond again. Hang on, let's hold back to separate corners. This is what I think you're missing, Geraldo. And look, I have so much respect for you. Let me finish here. It's the infrastructure. It's the fact that people don't obey the laws. It has a major impact financially on our educational system, criminal justice system, healthcare system, that we want to reward illegal activity. And in this particular case, had we taken advantage with the knowledge of the status of this guy, these three young African Americans may be alive today.
Do I have 30 seconds to respond?
I'll give you 20 seconds.
Okay, I'll take the 20.
I'll give you 28.
Thank you. In Washington State, there was the kidnapping on July 4th of the 12-year-old, ironically, immigrant child who was raped, kidnapped, and murdered. Zanny Linick, her name. Mm-hmm. All of the right-wing blogs, including some of the people who are contributors on this network, said a consequence of Americans' open-door policy because it was revealed that the perpetrator of the terrible crime was an immigrant from Thailand. So everyone, for 24 hours, the right wing was crazy about this case. What happened? Why aren't you hearing about this case anymore? Let me tell you. Because it turned out out. The guy was
over 28 seconds.
The stepson of an Army veteran. He was himself an Army veteran and a naturalized citizen who voted in 2002. I mean, so now the right wing doesn't care about that child.
We're going to pick it up right there.
Please.
It's being used as a political fact.
That's funny.
We'll come back in a moment. Still to come tonight, who reads more, liberals or conservatives? A new poll suggests Sean's side of the aisle are not exactly bookworms. We'll debate
it's
that.
Not true.
No.
Maybe there's something else.